Hello, welcome to my channel. If you're new here, I make art. My name's Nolan, and this is my original character, Asteroid. And today, I just want to start talking about the storyline and the lore and everything to do with him. And I'm going to break it down into many different parts. So, this is going to become a series. This is a puppet sculpture of him, and he's ever so kindly holding my mic for me. But yeah, I don't know, I'm in this phase of YouTube where I like to just post videos that are like this and very chill, sit back, talking, throw it on while you're cleaning. Whoops, I'm dropping a bunch of paint right now. Chill, talking, hang out, podcasty vibe. So that's what we're doing today. But I'm gonna start doing a series where I post these videos every other day or so, and like dive into the lore and everything and tell you about the characters so you can get to know them, so that when the comic books come out and comic strips come out and book series and movies come out, stuff like that, you'll understand. I've been doing this on TikTok, but they're 60-second videos, so I can only say so much. So I want to do ones that are like 10 to 15 minutes here and there, sporadically. But yeah, so let's just get into it. I'm going to start off with kind of the premise of his story, where his story starts, and what the majority of his story is about. This is Asteroid. He is an alien, and he lives up in space. And for majority of his life, he has not fit in. He's not liked by the people or the aliens up in space. For no real reason. The reasoning that everybody gives him, and the reasoning that he believes he doesn't fit in, is because he has two stars that orbit around his head. And on this puppet, you can't see that because I didn't figure out how to do it in a way that I liked, so ignore that. Every time I draw him, though, and he's pictured anywhere, he has his two stars. And these stars orbit his head, and he's the only one up in space who has stars. So despite it being such a minimal thing, that is what everybody focuses on with him, and he doesn't have anywhere that he fits in. People don't like him, people bully him, they tease him, they push him as far away from society and everybody as possible. And yeah, he knows that, he's very aware of that, and his entire story is just him trying to find a place where he belongs and feels accepted, and finding those people. He is around the age of 18. Here's a little bit of a timeline, because he ages, he's a character, and there's a timeline that goes with it. He lives up in space from birth until 18 or 19. At the age of 18 or 19, he leaves space to go to Earth. After some traumatic events happen with his one and only best friend, Celeste. Celeste is his best friend. They've been best friends since they were kids. She's the only person who doesn't treat him differently and is the only person he feels comfortable with. So that's his best friend. Something happens with her. when I'm telling you all this, I don't know what is meant to be kept a secret and what is okay to share, because there are definitely very important plot beats that I have written that I want to maintain, and I'm sure somewhere I've spoiled what happens along the way because I like to run my mouth, but something happens to Celeste, which then is the catalyst for Astrid to be like, that's it, I'm done here, I have to find somewhere where I belong. And his first stop is Earth. Growing up, he has admired Earth, he likes humans, and he has a very skewed perspective on us as humans down here on Earth. He watches a lot of movies, reads a lot of books, and in that media he consumes, the way that Earth has been pitched and portrayed is not necessarily how it is, and he thinks that all of the humans get along all of the time, and he has a very skewed perspective on it. So when he comes to Earth, he is faced with the reality that not only do the humans not get along with each other, they don't want anything to do with him. He's an alien. He's a freak. He's a weirdo. He's literally a different being. And he realizes that even on Earth, there's nothing, there's nowhere he belongs. So his story then turns into he has to find comfort and peace within himself and the people that he brings into his life. So that is the main bulk of the story of him. But throughout all of this, there's a bunch of adventures and there's twists and turns and there's very heavy plot points that just like ache. There's a lot of action. There's a lot of, it's very fictional. It's very dramatic, very emotional, good and bad. And there's just a lot that happens. And he goes through different parts of Earth, travels around, and we see a lot of different styles. He goes through a lot of different outfits. Him and his best friends on Earth that he makes when he gets here are involved in that. The three of them go all around and do all these different things and go on adventures. So there's kind of like three different segments to his story that I classify. We have before Earth, like before he comes to Earth, which is his life up in space, childhood, up until 18 or 19. Then we have the flee to Earth, which is like the mid segment, and that takes place, I say, like 19 to 21, and then we have post arrival, and that is kind of just less of his main story. There is a trilogy series, novel series that I am writing, which is going to be the main story of Astroid, the main thing that I want to push and share and tell is going to be that trilogy series, which I want to make a novel and hopefully one day a movie. Stop motion, we need more stop motion movies. So that's going to be the bulk of his story, and that story is like what I emphasize on. Some of the space stuff is in that story. Most of that story is his coming to Earth. And then I do have other novels and stories that happen after that trilogy, which are more just for fun and just to keep the story going and to continue his adventures with his two friends. So once he comes to Earth, he makes two friends. One of them is Otto. He is a tiny little robot. He's like 3 foot. he is a robot that was created by the government up in space that Asteroid is trying to flee from. So when he comes down, at first they don't get along, they end up befriending each other, and they become best friends. They're there for each other like nobody's business. Super loyal, best friends. I can tell you now, they will never fall out of a friendship. They will always be friends, as well as the friend that the two of them make at the same time, which is Lucille. Lucille is a human. She lives on Earth, and when Asteroid crash lands onto Earth, she's the first human to embrace him and welcome him and not treat him like a monster. So the three of them become best friends, and they do everything together. Lucille is a bit older than Asteroid. She's in her 30s, and by the time that Asteroid lands, he's like, well, when they meet, he's like 19, she's like late 20s, and then, you know, as they age, they're about 10 years apart, give or take. So she definitely teaches him a lot about humans, about interacting, about just life in general. She's got a lot of knowledge to share. And she's gonna have her own backstory and novels and comics, books and stuff, as well as Otto. The three of them will each get their own series. Astrid is the main bulk, and then the two of them probably won't get a trilogy series. Lucille might. Otto probably will not. But there's a lot of stuff that has gone down in Lucille's life, so there probably will be a trilogy. There might be a trilogy for Otto too. I don't know. It depends how much I can create. But Asteroid is the main one. And when I get to those two, I'll get to those two. Who knows when that will be. But the three of them are the main premise of the Asteroid trilogy. All three of them are going to be present in all three books, and they're all just as important as one another. Well, I guess I can't really say that, because Asteroid is the main character, but at the same time, all three of them are, but I guess they're supporting characters technically. I'm trying to think of what I can say. Let's just go into some random facts about Asteroid. Asteroid has a family. He's got a mom and a dad. He's the only child, no siblings. His mom died when he was very young. Like, I'm talking baby. So he never really knew her. His dad is there, looks after him, takes care of him, but they are not close. He doesn't have much of a relationship with his family. His real only connection in space is Celeste, and they're friends for as long as they can be friends for, until he comes to Earth. And yeah, he's about 5'11". His favorite food, his favorite snack is popcorn. His favorite meal, any kind of soup. His favorite drink is hot chocolate. He's got some items that are his favorite things that he takes with him when he leaves space to come to Earth. A plushie that his mom made for him before she died, obviously. His headphones with his CD player, his journal, his pens, and a blanket and a pillow that was also made by his mom. We learn a lot about his mom in the trilogy series, and there's very little that I can tell, because she is a big factor in his story, despite not being in his life at all. She's a big plot pillar, I suppose. But yeah, he's often alone. He spends a lot of his time in his journals, in his sketchbook, listening to music, watching movies, reading books. He doesn't like being outside because people are not nice to him, so he spends most of his time in his room and dreaming of a way to escape and where to escape to. And him and Celeste always talk about leaving space, leaving the planet that they're on to go somewhere else and be able to live and not feel excluded from everybody for no reason. Yeah, he's got no pets. I don't know what his favorite animal is. I don't think he even knows. That's something he will figure out once he comes to Earth. But on his planet, there are not any animals that are alive. There's a lot of robots up in space where he lives. I don't have a name for the planet yet. All I know is that up there, it is going to be very futuristic, very like retrofuturism. I have a bunch of different styles that I like, so different places in the universe of Asteroid have very different aesthetics. So up in space, it is very retrofuturism, spacey, high-tech place. He lives in a very cookie-cutter, Edward Scissorhands suburbs. It's highly monitored, highly surveillanced by the government. It is essentially a dictatorship up there. No freedom, nothing. Everything is very heavily surveyed, surveillanced, looked after, I don't know. And then when he crashes onto Earth, he crash lands in a town called Bliss in California. It's not real, fictional. But in Bliss, it's very desert, Western, Gothic, which doesn't really exist, I know, but I like to mix the two together, so it's very Gothic, Southern Gothic, mixed with desert, cowboy, Western, a little bit of the history on Bliss. I'll get into a full video on the entire history of Bliss one day, but Bliss is like a big farm town. It's not a big town at all. Very few people live there, and there's a bunch of different rodeos, different venues, and where he lands is in a place called Eclipse Ranch. And on Eclipse Ranch, there's a ranch and there's a motel. So there's Eclipse Ranch and Eclipse Ranch Motel. And Lucille, her family owns the motel. It's run down, not nice. Nobody stays there. It's not open for business. The venue is trash and rotted wood, and it's not nice. But he lands way far back in the desert behind Eclipse Ranch Motel. The land there is extensive. It goes on forever. So he crash lands deep into the lot of Eclipse Ranch Motel. And where he lands, there's no sign of civilization, so it's pretty far out there. So he just happens to walk towards the motel and is like, well, I guess I'm gonna stay here. And that is where he meets Lucille for the first time, which will be talked about in the book. But Lucille lives there, kind of, I think. I don't know. I change things a lot, so I don't really know. But she definitely lives there at least part-time. But she tells Astrid, make yourself at home. I want you to feel comfortable. You can stay here. I don't have a problem. Nobody goes there. Nobody stays there. So what's it to her? And she really wants to make sure that Astrid knows that he's okay there and that she's not like the other humans who will torment him, which he will find out very soon. But yeah, he has a horse when he gets to Earth. Not right away, but there's a horse in the stables of Eclipse Ranch because, like I said, Lucille's family owns the ranch. Lucille used to ride horses, and there's a horse there that she doesn't, it's her horse, but she ends up giving it to Astrid, and the two of them bond together. His horse's name is Toby, and Toby is a Blood Bay Bronco, which essentially is just a horse that is like very deep, rich, blood red coat, fur, I don't know what you call it, I think it's a coat. But yeah, I'm always working on this story and adding new things to it, but I want to start a series where I talk about all this stuff, so that's a little bit of a deep dive. Not even a dive, that was just like a little splash, actually, into everything, but yeah, please ask questions and let me know what you want to know or what you want to see. I can't even express how much of a surface level scratch that was. There's so much. I have timelines, I have books, I have so many notes, so much to talk about and share, but it's gonna take a minute for me to be able to get out full comic books, and obviously a novel is gonna take a long time. I am currently writing a novel called Asteroids Rodeo, which is being released chapter by chapter on Instagram and on my website, so if you want to check that out and read a little bit about him and about the other characters, you can read those. I will do a chapter by chapter analysis as well of those chapters as they come out. So far only 2 chapters are out, but that one's going to be just like a fun novel for you to read to get to know the characters, so that once the storyline comes out and the real meat of Astrid's story is released, maybe you'll care more. I don't know. It's more for fun, and it's also a way for me to practice and learn how to write. But yeah, next video I'll probably do an analysis on the first 2 chapters of that book and explain everything in detail a little more. But this is kind of just like dipping your toes into who he is. Each character has tons of lore. I could talk about this for hours, but I want to kind of cast out the line and reel you in if I can. But yeah, if you want to know more about this stuff, check my website, TikTok, Instagram, and ask questions. Comment down below. I'll respond to them, and I'll talk about them in the next video. And yeah, this is my everything. Asteroid and his universe is what I'm here to do and what I'm here to provide. So this is going to be something I work on for my entire life, and I have a lot to share. So yeah, I just don't know how to share it apart from like putting out finished works, but they're not done yet, so I need to kind of get a way to do that. And that's also what the comic strips are for, and I need to focus on those a little more too. But there's a couple comic strips, I think I've only done 2, that I've posted. I think a lot of them are still on my iPad to be finished, but yeah, that's it for today. Comment some questions, I'll answer them, and I'll see you in the next video when we talk about some more stuff. But yeah, that's all for today. Thank you for watching. Make sure you like and subscribe if you're interested in this stuff. And buy my art if you want. I have prints, stickers, sculptures. I sell tons of different things. T-shirts, tote bags, enamel pins, all that fun stuff. I have a Patreon too. If you want to join my Patreon and get prints and little goodies sent to you every month and learn more stuff. Yeah. That's all for today, though. So I'm going to go now. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. That's all. Goodbye.